Hi, I'm Peter Zanik, open source evangelist at OneIdentity, and today I will talk about security alerting made easy using Python. Let me give you a quick overview of what I will be talking about. First of all, I will try to define what is alerting. Then I will talk about two software I'm working with, sudo and Syslog-ng, which are regularly used to send alerting. Then I will explain how to do alerting the hard way, and finally I will introduce you to the AppRise Python library, which makes alerting much easier. So what is alerting? Alerting is a signal that warns of an attack or a danger. In the real world, it could be an air raid, a chemical disaster. I have similar loudspeakers installed close to my home, and I hear it each Monday for trial. Very nice sound. So, what is alerting in the real world? For sudo or Syslog-ng or whatever software you use in IT, it's a notification sent by your application when something suspicious or important happens. Traditionally, it was an email message. Nowadays, people expect to receive alerts on Discord, Slack, and other online services. Let's talk about sudo a bit. So, what is sudo? Sudo allows a system administrator to delegate authority by giving certain users the ability to run some comments as root for another user, while providing an audit trail of the comments and their arguments. So it's a lot more than just a prefix, what most people see from sudo. Here you can see a very basic sudo file on the screen. You see a single rule, it's the most typical setting. Members of the wheel group can do practically anything on your system. The columns of the configuration is who can do on which hosts, as which user, and which comments are allowed. But even this very simple configuration is useful, as you can see on your logs which user does what on your system. Sudo comes with a huge set of defaults. You can change and you can change these using the default statement, like you can change which path is considered to be secure, which environment variables to keep, or if you want to insult your users. These settings can also be user or host specific, like in this example. Members of the wheel group receive insults. So what are insults? These are fun but not always politically correct error messages when someone mistakes a password. It's sysadmin humor, I like it, but some people don't, so it's not enabled by default anymore. One of the lesser known features of sudo is session recording. You can record anything what is happening on the terminal and play it back just like a movie. It's quite difficult to modify as it's not clear text, but if it's saved just locally, then it's easy to delete them. So sudo 1.9 introduced central session recording to resolve this problem. Once you have more than one system, you want to implement some kind of central management for sudo. You can use LDAP for this, which has the advantage that it propagates in real time. Settings cannot be modified locally. And on the other hand, there are quite a few limitations. So it really depends on your environment if you want to use it. Sudo 1.9 also introduced Python support. You can extend sudo using Python scripts using the same APIs as you can use for C-based plugins. The advantage of Python is that there is no need for a dedicated development environment or compiling your software. One of the most popular APIs is the iolog API, iologs API, which lets you access any input and output from user sessions. And for example, using Python, you can break a session if a given text appears on screen, or analyze the command line and break a session if you see something suspicious there. Here is a short example. Anytime my secret appears on screen, the session is broken by sudo. So I prepared the test environment. I created a directory do not enter and placed the file there called my secret just in the Python code. So here the user starts a shell using sudo, changes to the root directory. Oh, there is a directory called do not enter. Let's look around what is in it. Enters the directory, tries to list it, but sudo, the Python code in sudo sees that my secret would appear on screen, and before that happens, it breaks the session. Let's talk a bit about Syslog-ng. Syslog-ng is an enhanced logging daemon with a strong focus on portability and high-performance central log collection. Originally, it was developed in C, but you can now extend it in Python and Java as well. So what is logging? It's a recording of events such as an SSH login message, but of course many others. Syslog-ng has four major roles. The first one is data collection. Syslog-ng can collect system and application logs together. It can collect log messages from a wide variety of platform-specific log sources. As a central syslog server, it knows all of the different syslog protocol versions and can collect logs over UDP, TCP, and encrypted connections. It can collect log messages and any kind of text data from applications. And if none of these sources suit your needs, you can create your own log source using Python as well. The next role is processing. You can classify, normalize, and structure log messages using built-in parsers. You can rewrite log messages, and you don't have to think about falsifying log messages. But for example, anonymization is required by different compliance regulations. You can enrich your log data using Syslog-ng. For example, add geographical location to IP addresses, and you can reformat log messages using templates. For example, Elasticsearch needs JSON formatted log messages, and so on. You can do processing also in Python using the Python parser. You can implement any of the above features in Python and many more. The next role is filtering, which has two main uses. Discarding surplus log messages, like throwing away debug messages, and message routing, like routing all your authentication events to a SIEM system, or also alerting needs filtering. You don't want to send all of your log messages to the notification service only. Just a few of them. Finally, you want to store log messages somewhere. Traditionally, you store log messages into flat files. Later, SQL and NoSQL databases were added. HTTP destination can send log messages to many different cloud services. Different message queuing systems are supported, and also you can extend Syslog-ng using Python and Java as well to write your destinations. A tricky question just to wake you up. What is common between the BMW i3 and the Kindle? No, it's not the color of them. It's both of them are running Syslog-ng. So let's get back to alerting. Both sudo and Syslog-ng support email-based alerting right from the beginning. Syslog-ng also supports the HTTP destination, which you can configure to send messages to many different destinations. On the other hand, it can be quite tiresome, as you need to read the documentation or reverse engineer the protocol for the different services. It's painful, and often it's not even possible when it needs a specific way of authentication or other hiccups. Here I want to show you how to do alerting to Discord using the HTTP destination. It's relatively simple. To implement this, first I had to read the Discord documentation, create a webhook in Discord, then continue reading the Discord documentation and find how to send alerts using curl, and then read our own documentation for the HTTP destination, and finally, based on all of this information, I could create a Discord destination for Syslog-ng. Here is the end result. It's you can see that you need to know quite a lot of things. A URL, which is easy, but then you need to know which method to send your information, set a user agent, headers, and also need to know how to format these alerts for the given destination. And when your colleagues ask for another service to use for alerting, then you can start it over from scratch. As I mentioned earlier, both sudo and Syslog-ng support Python. There are many Python libraries available for the different notification services, so you can support even more services using Python than with the HTTP destination, but it's still difficult as you need to implement each of these destinations separately. Or you can use AppRise. It's on GitHub and it's part of quite a few distributions, so it's quite it's easy to get started with it. And what is AppRise? It's a Python library sending notifications to 50 different services. Over 50. Getting started with it is quite easy. I will show you it through a Syslog-ng configuration. For this example, I don't use filters, just a network source. So what I send to the network source is sent to the sent as a notification. Here you can see the network source at the top of the screen, then the definition of the AppRise destination. As you can see, it's using Python. We utilize the AppRise class, send define which name value pairs to send to the destination, and the URL. And here We have the lock statement which connects these two together. In this case, I included the Python code in the Syslog-ng configuration, so it's not in a separate file but within the Syslog-ng configuration. In the initialization part, we initialize AppRise and set the URL, and we have another method called send, which is called anytime we want to send the notification. The fields of the notifications are hard-coded here, so it's not flexible. We send the message as the body and the date as the title. Still, it makes our life a lot more easy, as we did it now with Discord, but if colleagues want another service, then we just rewrite the URL and we are ready. But we can make it much more easy and flexible to use. First of all, we can use blocks in Syslog-ng, which hides away the implementation details from the user. The end user creating the configuration only needs to configure the URL and probably override which data to send, but doesn't have to know how it is exactly implemented. And using templates in the Python code, you can make the content configurable. Here is the block implementing the AppRise destination. You can see it expects a URL. You always have to give the URL, as there is no default value. There cannot be a default value for this, but title and body already have a default value, which you can override from your configuration later on. Here is the configuration part. So we are back to a network source, and as you can see, the destination is hiding away all of the details. You set here the URL, and in this case I overwrote the title, but a simple URL would be enough, and you don't see that it's Python. You don't see the header, the whatever parameters, only what you really need to change. And here is the Python code. As previously, we initialize AppRise in the init method, set up the URL, but the send method is different, as here we use templates. So we set the title and body based on these templates, and send the end results to the different notification services. When using sudo, alerting is done using the audit API of sudo, and you can use it also from Python. Here the difficulty is that most services are throttled. It means that you cannot flood a service with notifications, but you need to keep at least a second between sending notifications. The problem is that it slows sudo down quite considerably. You have many workarounds for this problem. You can aggregate log messages and send it only once as a one larger notification, or send only the really important log messages, Or you can be just patient and wait until all of the log messages are sent one by one. It's good for debugging, but otherwise not recommended. The code I implemented does a combination of these two. I mean, it aggregates log messages, but sends them in two batches. Not at once everything, as otherwise you might lose notifications. So the first set of log messages are sent when sudo accepts a command, approves a command, and the second one is when sudo finished running. Just think about when you reboot a system. If you sent the notification at the end of the sudo command, then that notification would be lost, as the system is restarting before it could be sent. Just as previously, we initialize AppRise in the init part of the code. We set up here the URL, and I also make it possible to send log messages synchronously, so that is also configured here. Here is when the a command is approved by sudo by the policy plugin, then we change a variable, so the notification is sent when the command is approved. And finally, here is the most important part, where we send the notifications. First, we set the message. If we do synchronous alerting, then we send the notification immediately and reset the message. Otherwise, we send the alert in two parts. First, when the sudo session is approved, and finally when the sudo session is finished. And here you can see a screenshot from here you can see a screenshot that the alerts arrived at the destination from sudo. Let me summarize my talk. So alerting lets you act on interesting IT events, but recently email alerts are no more enough. You want to send messages to different notification services. Python support in sudo and Syslog-ng enhances your alerting possibilities, and AppRise allows you to send alerts to 50 different services. If you have questions, then you can reach me by email or on Twitter. Thank you for your attention.